Today, Slack is where work happens, and getting updates directly delivered to Slack makes us all more productive. So today we'll walk through how to go from receiving messages like this, that are hard to read and offer little context, to messages like this, where the updates and info are clear and engaging. So right now, I'm working on a virtual sales bell automation, which will be used to update my team and I on recently won deals by our sales team. Now, I have the first version here, but we'll walk through how I can improve this post with four simple tips. By using Slack Markdown, using attachment message fields and attachment colors in Slack, and how to embed links with attachment message links. All right, so let's jump into it. Okay, so here we have the recipe that I've been working on. So when an opportunity is marked as closed one in Salesforce, the automation will post a message to a Slack channel with the relevant details. So let's click into step three. And on the right, we can see that we're posting the message to our Sales Bell channel. As the basic text, we're saying we're celebrating the latest deal closed by the sales rep. And we can see we're taking that from the data tree on the left side. And right below, we have the body of the text, which is the attachment. So the attachment title, we have the opportunity name, we have the name of the sales rep, and the revenue that is generated from this deal. And down below, we have a field called the attachment text. And right now we're posting other information such as the close date, deal type, and description. So this is how the recipe looks right now. And we'll walk through how we can modify it to make it more engaging and relevant. So first we'll start off with the basic text. The first thing we wanna do is make the text bold so it really pops out. So if we go into Slack, so Slack supports basic markdown. So if you type in an asterisk and then a message and surround that with another asterisk, it'll make the message bold. If you use an underscore, that'll make the word or message italicized. And if you use a back quote, that will create a code snippet. So let's go back into Workato. And if we surround the text with an asterisk, that should make the message turn out to be bold when it's posted to Slack. Next, what we want to do is, because this is a reason to celebrate for the sales team, whenever a deal is closed, that's a big deal, right? So we want to add emojis surrounding that particular message. So just like in Slack, how you can add an emoji, in Slack you can actually type out an emoji in a particular format. So that's actually colon, the emoji identifier, and then colon. So if I type out colon smile colon here, that emoji will actually appear. And this is particularly useful for custom emojis that are only available in your workspace. So we can go back to Workato, and in the recipe I can type in colon bell colon, and that should produce a bell emoji. And if we go to the right side, we can actually just use the emoji keyboard to alternatively add an emoji if it is one of the standard ones from the keyboard. So we'll click save. This looks good. So let's go to Salesforce, and here we have an opportunity called Fjord Motors. It's just a test deal to test out this recipe, and we have the opportunity owner, Devin. We have the close date, which is 4/30/2022, the amount, 50,000. They're an existing customer, and down below we also have the description. So I'll mark this opportunity as closed one, and click save. And we can see at the top that the stage was changed successfully. So let's go back to Workato and let's click test. And awesome, the recipe was a success. So let's click into step three to see what data came through. So here we can see that the basic text came through. We have the colon, bell, colon, and the emoji at the tail end, as well as the asterisks. And down below, we also have the attachment title, as well as the details listed below. And if we go to Slack, we can see that the basic text is now bolded with the emoji, both written in the Slack format as well as using the standard emoji keyboard. Next, what we want to do is, we can see that the body of this message, it has the details there, but it's not very clear, and it's hard to call out what information is important for a sales rep to see. So what we want to do next is actually make that body text more legible and readable for the sales team when they see a new deal is landed. So let's go back to Workato And if we look at the right, in the attachment text field, we have the information laid out. And it looks clear, but when it's posted to Slack, it's very hard to read. So below the attachment text, there's actually a field called attachment message fields. And the attachment message field posts message in a name value pair. So if you look below, you can actually write the name of the data field that you're referring to, colon, the data or the value that you want to appear underneath it. So in this example, it's name, colon, John. And we have our data written out in that format already. So we have the account name, which is the data field we want. And to the right of the colon, we have the data that we want to be moved over to Slack. So since it's already in that format, we can cut that text and paste it into the attachment message fields field. All right, so that looks good. So we'll click save. And since I want to test the same opportunity, I can actually go to test jobs. And because the trigger is cached from the last job, I can click repeat job and it'll run the same event. And we can see that the recipe was a success. So let's click back into step 3 to see what data came through. And on the right, instead of the attachment text, we have the attachment message fields. And it looks like it's written in the same format, but to see what's posted, let's move back over to Slack. And in Slack, we can see now instead of all of that text being bunched together, is presented underneath that bolded field name. So we have the revenue, and then underneath we have the $50,000 generated, the description, we have the description of the opportunity. It's great that all this information is clear, the header is popping out, the basic text, but it's hard to distinguish a new deal from an old deal. So if we look on the left side of the message, there's this gray bar, and we can actually change the color of that to make it pop out, and so you can easily identify when a new deal was posted. So if we go back into Workato, we can change the color. If we scroll down on the right side, there's this field called attachment color. And here you can change the color of the gray bar. So there's a couple options. There's red, which means danger. There's orange, which means warning. And there's green, which means good or is positive. And we'll pick good because this is a positive message. And then we'll click save. We'll go to test jobs, click repeat job. And there we go. So the recipe was a success. So if we click into step 3, on the right, we can see that the attachment color is good. And now if we move back over to Slack, the message is called out next to this green bar, which makes it easier on the eyes when a new deal is posted to this channel. Now, the last thing we want to do is we have this information we're posting here, but it doesn't provide the full picture. So if a sales rep wants to learn more about the account or the opportunity, we want them to be able to access the Salesforce opportunity without having to search it. So what we can do is actually, if we go back to Workato, if you notice underneath attachment title, there's a field called attachment link. And every attachment title can be turned into a clickable URL. And to provide the appropriate URL, what we can do is go back to Salesforce and grab the URL from this particular opportunity. And we can copy it and paste it into this field. Now, this particular link or URL will only take us directly to that one singular opportunity. But if you notice right next to the opportunity in the URL, there's the opportunity ID. So if we take that out, we can replace it with the opportunity ID from the recipe or the automation that's running. So it references whatever deal was closed most recently. So we'll replace that with the opportunity ID from the data tree and we'll click save. Now to demonstrate that it will take us to a separate opportunity, we have a different opportunity for the University of Arizona. We have Devin again as the opportunity owner. We have the amount of 90,000 and the close date of 6/6/2022. So we'll mark that opportunity as closed one. And we can see at the top, the stage was changed successfully. So now that we've marked that opportunity as closed one, let's test the recipe. And great, the trigger caught the change state. So let's click into step 3 to see the data. And on the right, we can see that the attachment title link is now there with the changed opportunity ID. So let's go back to Slack one last time to see if it went over. And awesome. Now the text is in this rich blue color, and if I hover over it, it prompts me to click into it. So if I click into it, it'll take me to the opportunity for the University of Arizona, which was just closed. So it makes it really easy for a sales rep to get additional details from closed opportunities and to learn more from others. So those are a few ways you can use basic Slack formatting in Workato to make messages pop. You don't have to go jumping from app to app to learn about what other teammates are doing. And it creates a seamless experience within Slack to stay up to date and more connected with your team in general. To learn more about Slack formatting, you can visit our docs at docs.workato.com. I hope this helps, and as always, thank you for watching.